Good morning students. In last lecture we already discussed about the triangle theorem 7.1 that is related to SAS congruency rule. Yes, now we are doing one question of exercise 7.1 question number 8. In right triangle ABC, this is the right triangle ABC. Right angled at C, it means this angle is equal to 90 degree. M is the midpoint of hypotenuse AB, it means AM is equal to MB. It joined to M, C is joined to M. C is joined to M and produce to a point D such that DM is equal to CM. It means it is also given to you that DM is equal to CM. Point D joined to point B, show that triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. It means we will discuss about these two triangles, BMD and this one AMC. Our first question is prove that these two triangles are congruent. Then start our solution. First part is triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. What is given to you? Given in right triangle, in triangle ABC, angle C is equal to 90 degree. M is midpoint, it means AM is equal to BM, CM is equal to DM. These all things given to you. Prove that, we take here, prove that this whole thing, here we are taking first part, that triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. Now we start our proof. See in this diagram, in these two triangles, this side equal to this given, this one equal to this given. What is the relation between this angle? This is a vertical opposite angle. So by side angle side rule, we can say these two triangles are congruent. So write down, in triangle AMC and triangle BMD, we can write down AM is equal to BM, CM is equal to DM. This is given. And the next, AMC is equal to BMD, reason vertically opposite angles. So triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD by SAS congruency rule. These are congruent. First part proof. Now see the second part. In second part, we have to prove that angle DBC. DBC, it means this angle 90 degree. See here, how to prove it 90 degree? 90 degree, for proving it 90 degree, this is already 90 degree. If we prove that BD parallel to AC, then this become a transversal and these two angle becomes a co-interior angle. Then this is 90, then this also 90. So it means firstly we have to prove that AC parallel to DB. How to prove it? In first part we already proved that these two triangles are congruent. If congruent, then by CP CT we can say this angle is equal to this. Yes or no? If we see this one angle is equal to this, which type of angle they are? They are alternate interior angle. So by converse of alternate interior angle theorem we can say AC parallel to DB. It means from the first part we can say that these two angles are equal, but these are alternate interior angle. So what we write in second part, that from part first, angle DBM is equal to angle MAC. Reason CPCT. With lines, with sides or lines DB and AC. Yes or no? DBM is equal to MAC. Now we can write down, but these are alternate interior angle. So by converse of alternate interior angle theorem, AC parallel to DB, or we can say DB parallel to AC. Now then angle DBC plus angle ACB is equal to 180 degree. Reason, co-interior angle this value it is sorry ACB it is already given to you that it is right angle triangle. So DBC plus 90 degree, here we write down angle C, or we can write down ACB is equal to 180 degree, then DBC is equal to 90 degree. Here given angle ACB is equal to 90 degree. So second part also prove that DBC is a right angle. Firstly prove by SCS congruency rule. Then after, I already told you whenever we want to prove the parallel lines, then we will use the concept of converse of corresponding angle axiom, converse of alternate interior angle theorem, or maybe converse of co-interior angle theorem. So here we are using the converse of converse of alternate interior angle theorem for proving these lines are parallel. After parallel there is a BC, is it transversal, then it becomes co-interior angle, then sum of these two angle is equal to 180 degree, then it becomes angle DBC is equal to 90 degree. Now see the third part, DBC and triangle ACB congruent. How to prove? In the first part C, when you prove it, then by CPCT we also can take DB is equal to AC. Yes or no? In this, if they are congruent, then AC is equal to BD. Now it means this line is equal to this. Next thing, BC in both triangle common. And third, this angle 90 degree, this also 90 degree. Then again if you see side angle side rule, with side angle side rule we can say DBC triangle is congruent to ACD. Do it. Third part now. Third part, that triangle DBC congruent to triangle ACB. Firstly, we write down from part first, DB is equal to AC, reason CPCT. Second, from second part, from part second, angle DBC is equal to angle ACB is equal to 90 degree. Third, BC is equal to BC, reason common. So by which rule? So by SAS congruency rule, triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. Third part also proved. Now see the fourth part. CM is equal to half of AB. So from part third, can I write down that CD is equal to AB? For proving the fourth part, we can write from part third, that triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB, then DC is equal to AB by CPCT. We can write down. Next, see CD. CD, can I write down CM plus DM? CD is equal to CM plus DM is equal to, we need AB as it is. Now in this it is given to you that CM is equal to DM. Then we can write down, need here CM, CM plus CM is equal to AB, 2CM is equal to AB, CM is equal to half of AB. Hence prove all parts. This type we will solve this question based on the congruency of triangle. Basically we are using here SAS congruency rule. And second thing, ASA, already explained to you ASA, angle side angle theorem, how to prove. And one more congruency rule we studied, angle angle side. Now see the theorem 7.2. This is your 7.1 exercise now complete. You should complete 7.1 exercise with example and theorem in your notebook. SAS congruency theorem is not proof is not in your syllabus this time now, but theorem 7.2 is in your syllabus. Proof also we will do. Before 7.2 theorem, we need to know about the isosceles triangle, that is property of a triangle. Isosceles triangle is what? In a triangle, if two sides are equal, then it is called a isosceles triangle. Any two sides of a triangle are equal, then we can say it is an isosceles triangle. Now our theorem 7.2 based on the isosceles triangle property. What is the isosceles triangle property? If two sides are equal, then their opposite angles are also equal. What is the opposite angle of AB? ए बी अपोजिट एंगल इज एंगल सी, ए सी अपोजिट एंगल इज एंगल बी. इट मीन्स इफ टू साइड्स आर इक्वल देन देयर अपोजिट एंगल्स आर ऑल्सो इक्वल. दिस इज द आइसोस्केलस ट्राइंगल प्रॉपर्टी एंड दिस इज आवर थ्योरम 7.2 स्टेटमेंट. वॉट इज द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ थ्योरम 7.2? In an isosceles triangle, angles opposite to equal sides are also equal. In an isosceles triangle, angles opposite to equal sides are also equal. This is your statement of theorem 7.2. It means in this theorem it is given to you that we take a isosceles triangle. See diagram. Firstly, we take isosceles triangle A, B, C, in which we take AB is equal to AC. So we can write down what is given to you. Given in triangle ABC, AB is equal to AC. Prove that opposite angle, angle C is equal to angle B. Now see, before proof there is a need of construction. In this we need a construction. What is the construction step here? That draw an angle bisector of angle A which intersect BC at D. Draw an angle bisector of angle A which intersect BC at D. Angle bisector meaning this angle, then angle bisector meaning these angles are equal. What we have to prove? That these two angles are equal. When you draw angle bisector AD, then see it is divided into two triangles, that is ABD, ACD. If we prove that these two triangles are congruent, then by CPCT we can say these two angles are also equal. Now see how to prove these two triangles are congruent. We need three elements to prove any two triangles are congruent. This is given to you that these side equal. If you see properly, then in both triangles this side is common side. And by construction we take that these angles are equal. Because we are taking the angle bisector. What is the meaning of bisector? Bisector means it divides, angle bisector means it divides any angle into two equal parts. It means this is angle A, then this is A by 2 and this is also A by 2. So if you see properly, which rule we can follow to prove these two triangles are congruent? SAS. So by SAS congruency rule we can say these two triangles are congruent. Or if they are congruent, then by CPCT ABD is congruent, is equal to ACD. Or this they are take, it is taking angle B complete angle, so we can write down easily that angle B is equal to angle C. Now take construction to draw angle bisector AD of angle A such that it intersect BC at point D. Okay, now we start our proof. In proof C, we write down in triangle ABD and triangle ACD. AB is equal to AC given. Angle BAD is equal to angle CAD by construction. AD is equal to AD common. So, or we can say thus, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle. Check it. With angle A, there is also angle A, then angle with A. Then B corresponding to C, D corresponding to D. Then angle ABD is equal to angle ACD. Reason write down here by SAS congruency rule. By CPCT. So we can say angle B is equal to angle C, hence root. So this is the theorem that in an isosceles triangle, angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Now theorem 7.3, just converse of this theorem. What is the converse of this theorem? That in a triangle, sides opposite to equal angles are also equal. In a triangle, sides opposite to equal angles are equal. It means now it is given to you, in triangle ABC, angle B is equal to angle C, or prove that AB is equal to AC. Construction same we will do, but now this time ABC, it is given to you B is equal to C. This we take equal by construction, and what we have to prove, AB is equal to AC. Here I write down D. Now seen these two triangles, this one is common both. If you see properly, angle side, by which rule we can prove angle side, we can say these two triangles are congruent. Same thing in triangle ABD is equal to ACD. Here what is given to you? Angle B is equal to, angle B I can say ABD is equal to ACD given. This one by construction, this one common. Then by which rule? Angle side congruency rule, we can say these two triangles are congruent. Then by CPCT, AB is equal to AC. Hence, proof. This is the converse of theorem 7.2. Converse theorem of 7.2. 7.2 theorem, converse statement it is. So, this time we will prove the theorem 7.2 and 7.3. Okay, student, now we will discuss इन आवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द एग्जाम्पल्स रिलेटेड टू दिस थ्योरम. सो टिल हेयर कंप्लीट एंड डू रिवाइज प्रॉपरली सेल्फ. ओके, थैंक यू स्टूडेंट.